Hanging out at the bar with your pals the other day.
So, CONvergence is moving to Minneapolis.
Well, Big Brother, it was already in Minneapolis.
Technically.
Well, you see, it was already in Bloomington, but now it's moving to the downtowns.
Wait, I thought Bloomington was in Indiana.
Actually, Katie, there are 15 different municipalities called Bloomingtons in the continental United States.
I think the more confusing part is that there's also a Bloomington and a Minneapolis in the state of Kansas, which, like Minnesota, is part of the American Midwest.
Allegedly.
It's just going to be a different hotel. Everything is going to be the same.
Except people can be trusted to, you know, throw a party.
Great job on that panel, everyone. Who wants some puppers?
Well, you know me, Big Brother. I'll always take a puppers.
I could kill some puppers right now.
Outstanding.
You know, I learned a lot in that panel.
You know, sometimes you can learn a lot from the people's knots on the panels. Them folks in the audience sometimes have some good ideas too.
Hard no.
Come on, Big Brother, don't harsh his squee.
Ugh, I hate that word.
What word, harsh?
No.
Brother?
No.
Bigs?
No.
Oh, squee.
You know, if I were a beloved family-friendly talk show host, I'd be Ellen Squee Generous.
What's your favorite M Squee U movie?
Oh, probably Guardians of the Galaxy Squee.
Did you see the latest episode of Star Trek Discover Squee?
No, I don't have Squeebs All Access.
Did you all catch Squeelo, a Star Wars story?
No, but I did see former CONvergence guest of honor, Emily Hagen's My Sucky Squeen Romance.
If I were a former CONvergence guest of honor, I'd be Wes Squee Chu.
If I were a former CONvergence guest of honor and a guest of honor returning this year, I'd be Bridget Lansquee.
If I were a novel by former CONvergence guest of honor, C. Robert Cargill, I'd be Squeen of the Dark Things.
Well, if I were a novel by the aforementioned Mr. Cargill, I'd be Squee of Rust.
Too bad about those degens from 4chan mucking up our panel.
I hate them degens from 4chans.
Wayne?
How are you now?
Good, and you?
Not so bad.
Actually, I'm terrible.
Well, sorry to hear that, but from your general disposition, I imagine you might be partially to blame.
They wouldn't put us on a panel because we're white men.
Are you sure?
What panel did you suggest anyway?
Top 27 reasons The Last Jedi ruined Star Wars and our childhoods.
Ah, you're gonna Tom Bombadil it.
Yups, a total Tom's Bombadils.
What?
Tom Bombadil, Big Shoots.
Master of Wood, Water, and Hill.
Bright blues his jacket is, and his boots are yellows.
I'll freeze your sap.
You see, in the Fellowship of the Ring, the hobbits were on their way to Bree, Merry and Pippin were screwing around and got caught by Old Man Willow.
Damn those anthropomorphic Middle-earth trees.
Frodo and Sam not having any weapons to speak of.
Seeing as they hadn't even been to Bree yet, let alone gotten to Rivendell's.
Frodo and Sam cry out for help.
Enter Tom Bombadil.
Old Tom does some first-level D&D magic-type stuff. Nothing too crazy or really all that cool-looking. And the tree lets him go.
So
rather than pack him a lunch and wish him good day, Tom invites him back to his place in the forest.
You never goes back to a strange person's house that you meets in the forests, no matter how yellow his boots is.
The hobbits spend 2 whole days in Tom's home, where Frodo has some bad dreams.
Prophetic dreams, Big Brother.
You're right, Katie. They were prophetic dreams. But it makes no storytelling sense to require the hobbits to meet a new character, spend 100 pages just hanging out in his cabin where he sings about the architecture of his house. Then when they leave, they never meet him again. Nor are they changed in any way as characters themselves, just for Frodo to have a couple of dreams that he could have easily had anywhere else along their journey.
Well, I for one am glad that Mr. Peter Jackson left that out of his movies.
Even the extended editions.
You know when you were kids and you would go outside and your mom would call out, "Make good choices!" Peter Jackson listened to his mom, and he made a good choice.
Well, except for making The Hobbit into a trilogy.
Well, to be fair.
To be fair.
To be fair!
How much of that was his choice? And how much of that was the studio's interference?
Excellent question, Squirrely Dan. We should write that down and suggest a panel on that very topic for next year.
How does that have anything to do with me?
Because, friendo, sometimes you don't want to spend an hour in an echo chamber when you know full well you're not going to change anyone's mind and your mind isn't going to be changed neither. It's like you wasted 100 pages of an otherwise good book just mucking about and everyone goes their separate ways.
Twitter will listen to me.
I hate those degens from 4chan.